Hi, that's Frederick from Fred's Lab, and I'm going to present you how to use your OPA Shield with the computer and the software editor. But before we move on with the video, make sure your setup is complete. First of all, you need an Arduino board, you need your OPA Shield, and you need them both assembled. Once you have done that, then you can connect to the computer the Arduino board with a regular USB cable and connect the audio. Let's make some music now. So we are now on my Windows computer and we're going to see one use case of the OPA Shield, which is using the OPA Shield as an external synthesizer for producing music in a home studio environment. Before we start to make music with the OPA Shield, we're going to make sure that we have all the tools that we need to do that. So the first thing that you have to make sure that is installed on your computer is the Arduino development environment. This you can download it from arduino.cc and it's meant to transfer Arduino sketches to your Arduino board. You also need the latest version of the OPA editor, here's version 0.8. You can download it from my website, and you need a virtual MIDI port driver. First thing we're going to do is we're going to transfer one sketch to the Arduino board to tell the OPA Shield that is going to work with the editor. So you have to open the OPA editor archive here, and inside there's something called the editor bridge, and this is a very simple sketch, so we're going to open it together. This sketch just configure the pin, just transfer it to your Arduino. So once the sketch is transferred, the Arduino is ready, so we can just close that. And now we're going to launch the editor. So the first thing you see here is the interface. You see the four operators, which is per program. This is where you configure your synthesis parameters. So you can see here you have the envelope per operator, the coarse parameter, the volume here, the amount of LFO effect, and you have this right panel, which is per program. So on the OPA Shield, you have 8 programs that can sound simultaneously, and you can switch from one to another for editing like this. This is the volume per program, depending on the stereo field. You can also configure some things related to the voice stealing, and here access to stored or internal stored presets. And this is the global, so this affects the whole shield. The first thing you're going to do is we're going to connect the shield. So here in the menu connection, you should see Arduino on COM18 or another COM depending on your system. So this tells the editor to which port, to which serial port your Arduino is attached. So we're going to select this one. It's easy here because there's only this one. As you can see, it already connected and got the parameter from the default preset. So it's exactly what it is at the moment on program 1. And I can go to program 2. It should be the same. So there's no changes. The second thing we're going to check is MIDI connection. So we're going to attach a keyboard to the editor. So here I have a Roland A500, so you should see your own MIDI device here, so in order to test if the module is working. Starting from now, you should be able to play some note on the keyboard and hear the sound. So this is just the basic preset, so it's just a sine wave. I can directly edit it, changing the volume or adding one operator. So we have now the connection between the Arduino board, the computer, and the MIDI device. What we want to do now is to control the OPA Shield with the MIDI sequencer software, so we can use the Shield as an external multi-chamber instrument. As you can see here in the connection menu, there is no way we can connect to an external software. And this is when we need the virtual MIDI port. So we're going to configure it now. Loop MIDI offers you the way to create a virtual MIDI port on Windows. So we're just going to make one loopback port and we're going to call it OPA. That's it. So you can close the window now. Back to the editor. We just have to refresh our connection list here. And we see now this OPA port. We're going to select it and select again the serial communication. Now the OPA Shield is completely configured as an external MIDI instrument. We can open our MIDI sequencer software, which is here Ableton Live 9. And open one of the demo tracks. Here you can see all the tracks which are composing this song. And what's important to check about these tracks is their configuration. They all need to send their note to the OPA shield. As you can see here on the first track, which is called OPA Bass, it's sending its note to the OPA on channel 1. And this is the virtual MIDI port we configured with Loop MIDI. On the second track, the OPA Rhythmic Synth, it's also sending the notes on the OPA shield, but on channel 2, and so on. So now we're gonna check the communication between the software editor and the MIDI sequencer software. Let's select the first track. When the first track is selected, I can actually play note on my keyboard and check the communication between the MIDI sequencer software and the software editor. So let's do that. As you can see here, the MIDI LED from the program number 1 lights up, so it means that we have a proper communication between the two software. Let's now try on track 2. And as you can see, it's the second MIDI LED that lights up. So what it means is we can actually map program's number to MIDI channel and therefore to tracks. And this is perfect for composing song with multiple instruments. Let's now try to play our song. As you can hear, the OPA shield is playing all the instruments, but with the wrong programs. So let's pick up the right program. Here you can see program 1 is selected, so we can open the file and load the preset. So, since program 1 is associated with track 1, which is OPA bass, let's load the bass and play that track again. It sounds more like a bass. So we can do that with all the instruments and I leave the track running. We can also do mixing on the fly. I hope you enjoyed the video and you know more about the OPA Shield and its potential. See you next time.